Hello, neighbor. This is Pastor Jimmie proclaiming the truth with words of encouragement. As I say every week, greetings in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. God is still on the throne. The Bible is the Word of God, and Jesus is Lord and coming soon. Well, today's subject is, so you want to be a success, you just need to change your attitude. This is lesson number 4 on attitude. Before we go into the lesson, I want to make an announcement. If you're watching Christian World TV, or if you want to help somebody find it, you can go to ChristianWorldTV.com, and where it says view more videos, you click on there, and it lists all the people for you that you want to listen to. Or you can go on YouTube and type in the name of that person, like mine, Dr. Jimmie Keasling, or Evangelist Pat Talbert, or Reverend Dr. Mac Clemens. You type their name in, and it'll bring you up all their programs. So remember that. People say it's been hard to find. Go on YouTube, type in the name of the individual that you want to hear, and you'll be able to get their programs. Now, let's get to the lesson. Your attitude, neighbor, determines your attainments. Last session, we talked about doubting Thomas. I hope and pray that you're not a doubting Thomas. But today, we want to talk about a man called Paul. Before his name was changed to Paul, his name was Saul. And we want to talk about him today. He was born Saul of Tarsus, a Jew, and of the tribe of Benjamin, a Hebrew of Hebrews. Here are a few things you should know about Paul. He had never met Jesus. He hated Christians. Can you imagine the Apostle Paul that we love so much hated Christians? He thought Jesus was a fraud. He even consented to the death of Stephen. When Stephen died, he held the cloak. I want you to turn in your Bibles to Acts chapter number 9, and let's read some scripture about the Apostle Paul, or Saul, who became the Apostle Paul, from a persecutor to a preacher. Chapter 9, verse 1, and Saul, yet breathing out threatenings and slaughter against the disciples of the Lord, went unto the high priest, and desired of him letters to Damascus, to the synagogues, that if he found any of this way, before they were Christians, they were called the way, whether they were men or women, he might bring them bound unto Jerusalem. And as he sojourned, he came near Damascus, and suddenly there shined around about him a light from heaven. Wow. And he fell to the earth and heard a voice saying unto him, Saul, Saul, why art thou persecuting me? And he said, Who art thou, Lord? And the Lord said unto him, I am Jesus, whom thou persecutest. Is it hard for thee to kick against the pricks? And he, trembling and astonished, said, Lord, what wilt thou have me to do? And the Lord said unto him, Arise and go into a city, and it shall be told thee what thou must do. Yes, one day, on the road to Damascus, with letters to arrest the Christians, God blinded Saul with a bright light, and Saul fell off his horse to the ground, heard a voice from heaven saying, Saul, Saul, why are you persecuting me? And Saul answered, Who art thou, Lord? And the voice from heaven said, I'm Jesus, whom thou art persecuting. Then Paul said, Lord, what would you have me to do? What would you have me to do? You know, that's a great question. You should ask that question yourself today. What would you have me to do? You may have a talent. You may be able to teach Sunday school. You may be able to give. You may be able to preach. You may be able to be a missionary. But you should ask the Lord, what would you have me to do? See, We're not saved by works, but what we do is we work out our salvation. We're thanking the Lord for saving us, and we need to be about the Father's business doing things. Now, what do you mean, Pastor Jimmie, about doing things? Well, we need to be teaching and preaching and singing and soul winning and telling people about Jesus, baptizing them and discipling them so that they can go out and tell people how to be saved and baptize them and disciple them. It's a cycle. We just keep on doing things for the Lord. Matter of fact, the Bible said to him that knoweth to do good in James and doeth it not, it's a sin. So you need to be asking the Lord this morning, like Paul or Saul on the road to Damascus, what would you have me to do? You need to be doing something. Change your attitude. After receiving his sight, his name was changed to Paul, and he became the greatest preacher outside of the Lord Jesus Christ, and he carried the gospel of Jesus throughout the Mediterranean, and he established many churches. Here's a man 1 minute consenting to the death of Stephen, holding the clothes, then going and get papers to get Christians arrested. Then he fell off the horse. He saw a bright light, fell off the horse. And the next thing, this man's name is changed to Paul, and he become the greatest preacher outside of Jesus that ever lived. Paul wrote most of the New Testament. He talked with angels and was given a guided tour of heaven. And all he could say about the New Jerusalem was this. Now listen to what Paul said. I have not seen nor ear heard, nor have entered into the heart of man the things which God has prepared for those that love him. Do you love him this morning, neighbor? Do you really love Jesus? Listen, what is the last time you said, I love you, Lord. I love you, Lord. I thank you, Lord. When is the last time you said that? He said, I had not seen. Listen, heaven is a prepared place. And if you want to go there, you must believe on the Lord Jesus Christ. Like the old Negro preacher said one time, everybody's talking about heaven, but not everybody's going. Listen, there's people today that talk. They're not going to heaven. They go to church. They pray. They do these things. Your attitude determines your attainments. You can go to church, you can pray, you can sing, but if you have an unforgiving spirit, listen, most people in the church think that sin is adultery, murder, lying, and so forth, but listen, an unforgiving spirit is sin, and there's people in the church that have an unforgiving spirit. Years ago, I had an unforgiving spirit, and I didn't realize it. I wouldn't admit it did I realize it. And I was taking communion, and I kept getting sick and sick and sick. Well, the Bible says, for this cause many are sick and weakly among you. For what cause? Not having the right attitude, not confessing your sins. I had an unforgiving, resentful spirit towards somebody. Oh, I know you don't never have that. You can sing, but if you have an unforgiving attitude, God cannot and will not bless you. God cannot and will not bless you. By having the right attitude, you will attain much more than heaven. God's got so many things in store for you. Here's what Paul said. Eye has not seen, nor ear heard, nor have entered into the heart of man the things which God has prepared for those who love him. Do you love him? Well, he's got a lot in store for you. I thank God that there's a heaven. I thank God that I'm going to be there. And if you want to go to heaven, you must believe on the Lord Jesus Christ. My favorite scripture was Romans 10:9, that if thou shalt confess with thy mouth and believe in thy heart that God has raised him from the dead, thou shalt be saved. And I still like that. But one day I was going through Proverbs, and I'm going to turn into the book of Proverbs, and I want you to listen to it. Proverbs chapter 3, and this became part of my life's verse, Proverbs 3, verses 5, 6, and 7. Now get your Bible out and let's read this. Verse 5, 6, and 7. Trust in the Lord. Notice what he says. Trust in the Lord with all thine heart and lean not to thine own understanding. In all thy ways acknowledge him, and he shall direct thy paths. Be not wise in thine own eyes. Fear the Lord and depart from evil. So first thing he wants us to do is trust him. The second thing he wants us to do is acknowledge him. The third thing he wants us to do is stop sinning. Stop sinning. You say, if I sin, will I lose my salvation? No, but you lose the joy of the Lord. Listen, a true Christian can't enjoy living in sin. The Spirit of God will work on your heart, and I'm telling you, neighbor, you'll melt down and one day confess that you're sorry for your sin. Not sorry that you got caught, but sorry for your sin. So your attitude determines your attainment. You can attain a lot down here on earth. First of all, he blesses us. I like that song, Thank You, Lord, for Your Blessings on Me. I've got food on my table. I got a roof over my head, food on my table, shoes on my feet. Listen, we all have that. We're in times of trouble, but most of you sitting there, neighbor, has food on the table, shoes on your feet. You have a good place to eat. You have cover. You have a house to live in or an apartment, wherever. Thank God for it. Well, by having the right attitude, you attain much more than heaven. Much more than heaven. And I want the much more. I don't know about you, neighbor. By having the right attitude. Now, that's something to think about. In closing, I ask you to find your good Bible preaching, teaching church and serve the Lord. Until next time, may the Lord bless you and may it keep you, and may your troubles be less and your blessings be more, and may nothing but happiness come your way. Nothing but happiness. Now listen, there's some sad times, and that's why you need the strength of the Lord. The joy of the Lord is our strength. Listen, and don't you forget to tell somebody about Jesus. Whatever you do, tell somebody about Jesus. Until next time, neighbor, as I say every week, I'll see you here, there, or in the air. God bless you.